Welcome to the viewers for the lecture in RCC. In RCC, we have discussed so far about retaining walls. Now, in this lecture, we will take RCC water tanks. In RCC water tanks, already we had one lecture in which we have introduced water tanks, the different types of tanks, the codes to be used for design of water tanks, the different components to be designed in the case of water tanks, and then we have discussed a tank with a flexible base. We have taken a numerical example in which we have designed the dome slab and also the ring beam. We know that the dome slab is subjected to two types of stresses. One is meridional thrust and meridional stress, and then the other one is that of hoop stress. And also we have discussed the ring beam, because we have designed the segmental dome. We have not designed hemispherical dome. We have designed spherical dome, not hemispherical. If it is a hemispherical dome, the force that is transferred from one ring to the other thing, namely the meridional thrust, in the last ring will be vertical if it is a hemisphere. But actually we are doing only segmental or spherical dome. So the angle, we have found out the angle to be about 45 degrees or 46 degrees. Therefore, when that force transferred to the last ring is at an angle of inclination, the horizontal component of that force will cause a hoop tension, and for which you have to provide a ring beam. So that's what we have discussed. And we know how to design a ring beam, how to find out the, because the hoop tension is a direct tension, therefore directly you can find out the steel, T by sigma ST will give the area of steel required. And then we have designed the stirrups, shear stirrups, and we have seen that the stirrups provided in the beam are extended into the dome slab, because in the dome slab we have provided the reinforcement for the hoop, I mean not hoop tension, meridional thrust, top to bottom we have provided at a spacing of 180 mm center to center. So we have provided the reinforcement for the ring beam also, namely the stirrups at 180 mm center to center. So what we have done is, we have discussed is the hoop slab, the hoop reinforcement, or we can say the shear stirrups. The shear stirrups provided in the ring beam, we have extended onto the dome slab and connected to the reinforcement available on the dome slab, because both are at the same spacing. So this has been extended and lapped, overlapped with that of the dome slab reinforcement. So that's what we have discussed so far. Right now, now we'll take up the design of the tank wall. So up to this, you have completed up to two-legged stirrups will be provided at 180 mm center to center. And this will be lapped with the meridional reinforcement of the dome, that we have done. Now we will take up the design of the tank wall. Now we have taken the case of a tank with a flexible base. So in the case of a tank with a flexible base, the only force to which we have to design is that of the hoop tension. Hoop tension is equal to PD by 2. P equal to W into H. W is the unit unit of water, H is the depth of water. That's all. It's a triangular pressure diagram having a maximum pressure of W into H at the bottom. So that is the only force for, no bending moment, nothing. Therefore, even though there are number of steps, design is simple and straight. So we have to concentrate on one thing, and other things are there, but main concept is only that, right? So maximum hoop tension, diameter is 14 meters, diameter we have already decided, diameter 14 meters, and h equal to 4 4 meters including freeboard. So maximum hoop tension is equal to W into H equal to P D by 2, P D by 2. So P equal to 10 kilonewton per meter cube. So what for water can take 10 kilonewton per meter cube or 10,000 newton per meter cube or it is actually 9,810 newton per meter cube. 9.81 kilonewton per meter cube. So we have taken a round number 10,000. So a small increase in the load for rounding the number will give only a safer design. We are not that much increasing. 9810, we made it as 10 kilonewton per meter cube. So 10 into 4 WH into D diameter 14 by 2 equal to 280 kilonewtons. So this is the hoop tension. So this is the main force, right? Hoop steel per meter height equal to T by sigma S is a direct tension. Hoop tension is a direct tension. So 280 into 1000 by sigma ST equal to 130. We know for tar steel as per IS 3370 part 2, the allowable stress is 130 newton per mm square, right? So 2150 mm square. So providing 16 mm diameter bars, spacing equal to area of 1 bar into 1000 by AST, general RC design. RC design. So 201 into 1000 by 2154, 93.3 mm. Now we provide the steel on both faces. Let us make it as 90 mm, right? When we provide the steel near each face, we can provide the steel 180 mm center to center. That is, zero millimeter if we provide the steel on the left hand side, when we provide on both faces, and it will be at 90 millimeter on the right hand side, 180 on the left hand side, 270 on the right hand side, 0, 90 in between, 0, 90, 180, 270, 360 like that. So on each face, we will be providing the steel at 180 mm center to center, but practically when you consider the total thickness, the bars will be available at 90 mm center to center. Therefore, AST provided equal to 2 into, in each spacing we have got 1 bar, so 2 into 2 bars, 2 into 201 into 1000 by spacing adapted spacing. So that gives 2233. We require 2154, we provide 2233. So 2233 mm square is the steel that is provided, because later also the number will be repeated. So and next is that of the wall thickness. That is the only main force that we have done, we have completed, right? Next is that of the thickness of the wall. Coming to the wall thickness, allowable tensile stress under direct tension for M25 concrete is, this is for again from IS 3370 part 2, it is given in the form of a table. For bending tension, it is 1.8 newton per mm square, and direct tension, it is 1.3 newton per mm square. Right. So the wall is under tension, hoop tension, direct tension. Therefore, the force divided by area equal to stress. T is the force, hoop tension. AE is the equivalent area. Equivalent area means concrete contains steel also. Therefore, we have to convert in terms of concrete area, M times sigma ST. Therefore, the formula is already known. M minus area of concrete plus M minus 1, because that 1 is already included, therefore M minus 1 times AST. So that sigma CT is available, T is available. In area equivalent, only concrete area will be unknown. So that we are going to use and find out the. Now, before proceeding with that step, this I want to show it now. So actually this is the wall. Wall is of 210 mm thickness. Now 210 mm is to be designed. First we will design and come back, right? Yes, this is the tension, 280 into 1000 by area of concrete is 1000 into T, 1 meter into thickness, plus M minus 1 into AST. M is actually 280 divided by 3 times sigma CBC. So 280 divided by 3 into 8.5 will be 10.98. We have made it as 11. That's all, right? That gives, area steel is already known, I told you that we will require this value for later use, that is 2233. So this is also already available. So only unknown is that of T. So solving, the thickness equal to 193 mm. So 210 mm thick wall will be provided. Now we have decided the wall thickness as 210 mm. Right. Now we will go back to the figure. Yes, it's a figure. 210 is the wall thickness and 16 mm diameter at 180 mm center we have designed. Now this 16 mm diameter at 180 mm center is designed for the maximum pressure at the bottom at a depth of 4 meters from the top. So when you go up, it will be 3 meters, 2 meters, 1 meter like that. When the height h becomes less, the hoop tension will be less, the steel requirement will also be less. Either we can take smaller diameter of the bar and maintain the same spacing, or we can take the same diameter of bar and increase the spacing. So we have to take care of the maximum allowable space. So that is another important point. So here at the bottom we have provided this. Now we are going to increase the spacing when we go towards the top. That's we will do it and come back. Actually this is 16 at 180, this is 16 to 200 mm center, that is up to 3 to 4 meters, that reinforcement that you have designed earlier, then 3 to 2 meters one spacing, and above 2 meters another diameter of bar and a spacing. This is what we are going to design. So yes, this is where you have stopped. Yes, 190 mm, 210 mm, right, we have stopped here. Now spacing of hoop steel, when we go towards the top, the hoop steel has been designed for the maximum pressure at the bottom. The spacing can be increased at lesser depth levels of water. So minimum steel reinforcement equal to 0.24%, that is 0.24 by 100 into 1000 into 210, 504 mm square. So when we provide lesser steel at the top, we should not go below the minimum steel. That is why we have to find out the minimum steel at one stage, right. Now coming to this, at 1 meter from the bottom, that means h equal to 3 meters. ASC required equal to same W into h, that is P into D by 2. So P into D into kilonewton to newton. This is 2 into P, that is P, H, this is WHD by 2, WHD by 2, by 2 into sigma HD, that is the area of steel equal to T by sigma ST. Sigma ST equal to 130. So the formula is available here. Right. Using same 16 mm diameter bars, spacing is equal to 124. Previously we got 93.3. Now 124. Let us make it as 100. So above 1 meter from the bottom, because bottom 1 meter, 16 mm diameter at 180 mm center. Now above 1 meter from the bottom, the same bars will be provided at 200 mm center. We can increase the spacing also near each face alternatively, as we have discussed earlier. Again, at 2 meters from the bottom, a different level, h equal to 2 meters. Therefore, substituting in the same formula, accepting change of diameter, change of depth from 3 to 2, the area of steel required equal to 1077 mm square. So spacing, now we are going for a lesser diameter of bar, 10 mm diameter bars. So for 10 mm diameter bar, spacing equal to area of one bar into 1000 by AST required equal to 146 mm. Hence, about 2 meters from the bottom, 10 mm diameter bars will be provided at 130 mm center to center near each face, alternatively again. So this will be continued up to the top of the, so we have provided three types of steel. For the bottom 1 meter, 16 mm diameter at 180 mm center to center. Next 1 meter, the same 16 mm but 200 mm center to center. For the top 2 meters, 10 mm diameter bar at 130 mm center to center. So, three different spacings we have adopted. Right. Next is that of the floor slab. So, coming to the floor slab, the tank is resting on the ground. No pressure from the top, no pressure. Water pressure is there. Water pressure will be directly taken by the soil. It is resting on the ground. Right. On the ground or maybe a very nominal depth, some 40 centimeters, 30 centimeters like that, right, on the ground. Therefore, minimum thickness and a minimum reinforcement will be sufficient. Nominal thickness and also nominal steel will be sufficient. So, minimum steel equal to 0.24 into, assuming a thickness of 150 mm for the base slab. Base slab thickness will assume as 150 mm, right. Minimum area of steel equal to 360 mm square. Adopting 10 mm diameter bar, spacing equal to 218 mm center to center. Therefore, let us provide 10 mm diameter bars at 180 mm center to center in both directions. 180 required is at 218. We will provide at 180 mm center to center. And as per the revised code, when the thickness is less than 300 mm, we have to provide only one layer on the top. That is a caudal provision. So that's about the tank with a flexible base. Tank with a flexible base. Only hoop tension, nominal vertical steel, base slab, nominal thickness, nominal reinforcement. Dome slab, again, all the stresses are within the very much less than the allowable value. There also, nominal steel, nominal rein. Only main thing is that of the hoop tension and steel for that. Other things are right. General, right? You can do it, right? Now, this is just to show you a model. This is taken from the book by Professor Krishna Raj. So, this is to show how to show the reinforcement detail. Of course, this will not match with our design, but still, how a reinforcement sketch will not be provided, cross section and a plan will not be provided. So, this is the main steel for the, steel for the hoop meridional thrust. The line shows the steel for the meridional thrust. The dots show the reinforcement for the hoop tension. So, this is the ring beam 200 mm by 200 mm, we have decided. So, we have provided 4 bars of 20 mm and also the stirrups at 180 mm center center. The stirrup will be extended and connected with the meridional thrust reinforcement. So, this is the sidewall. Sidewall is subjected to hoop tension. So, we have to provide the hoop tension steel, then distribution steel, like that we have to provide. And here, this is a base slab. So, base slab, we have to provide one layer of bar. As per the revised code, you have to provide one layer and we have designed a 10 mm thick diameter bar at 180 mm center to center in both directions. So, here we have to see that we have designed a tank with a hinged bottom. So, here there is no connection between the reinforcement of the wall and that of the base slab. And again, as per the code, we have to provide some minimum thickness of plain concrete below the base slab. So, this will give you a very good guideline. So, you can refer any book and just read. So, this is the reinforcement for the floor slab. In both directions, we have provided 10 mm at a, here it is 8 mm. In our design, it is 10 mm at 180 mm centered center, part of the plan. So this is in the case of the dome slab. So the line, this line shows the reinforcement for the meridional thrust, and this line shows the reinforcement for the hoop stress. Normally, near the crown, when you provide reinforcement in both directions, the reinforcement will be very much congested. Therefore, generally a separate mesh of reinforcement will be provided near the top of the dome. So here they have shown the reduced reinforcement plus it will be provided in the form of a mesh. So this is to give an idea about how to draw the cross section, how to draw the plan of the dome slab reinforcement, how to draw the plan of the base slab reinforcement, right? So this will give an idea, right? So that completes the design of a tank with a flexible bottom, only hoop tension, right? Now we will take up the next design, namely design of a circular tank resting on ground with a rigid base, fixed base. So fixed base means this will be subjected to bending moment, bending hoop tension, and also shear force, right? So for which we have got a table, we have got tables. Previously, in the earlier design also, we have a table for design of circular tank with the hinged bottom, for which also for hoop tension there is a table, but that we have not used. We have simply used WHD/2, right? Better to use IS code. That is also directly the value, the coefficient, formula. Every detail is available in the code book itself, right? Now, when we discuss the next design using IS code, we will know things better. Now, for this, there are three tables. One table, now here is a tank with a fixed base. One table for finding out the tension, one table for finding out the bending moment, and one more table for finding out the shear at the base. Three tables are available, and the formula is available. Figure is available, tension where it occurs, minus means what, plus means what, is available. If we know how to use the code, that is, and other things only are normal RC design, finding out the spacing of steel or area of steel, diameter of steel, all these things are only routine RC design. So what is that you are going to learn new in the water tank design, related to water tank design? That alone, if you are separating, then it will be easier. Otherwise, if you see number of pages and number of calculations, it also will be a difficult problem. It is actually simple, right? I'll just discuss the problem, right? Design a circular water tank resting on ground. Capacity of the tank is same problem that you have taken earlier. The depth of the tank is 3.8 meter, freeboard 200 mm. The walls of the tanks are restrained at the base or fixed at the base. Here the reinforcement of the side wall and that of the base slab will be monolithic, right? So there will be no joint as in the previous case, right? So this that we'll discuss later. And use M25 concrete, Fe415 steel, and draw the cross section of the tank and also a plan of the tank showing the reinforcement details. Now design, 3.8 meter, 0.2 meter, diameter 14 meters and sigma, and here it is subjected to, we are designing by working stress method. So this tank will also be subjected to bending moment. We are doing the design by working stress method. So that means first you have to find out the formula for lever arm, formula for moment and resistance for the given steel and the concrete. So M25 concrete, for which sigma CBC equal to 8.5 Newton per mm square, sigma ST 130 Newton per mole as per the code 3370. M equal to 11. 10.98, we have taken it as 11, right? Now, so this is our elementary calculation that we do in the working stress method, how to find out the depth of neutral axis, 0.48418D, lever arm JD equal to 0.86D, because this lever arm formula we will be using later. Similarly, moment resistance, 1.528BD square, later we will use this formula, this 0.86D and also 1.528D, BD square, which is the moment resistance, that also we will be using. So this you have to calculate for working stress method of design, right? Now, first we have to assume the thickness, because the calculation of or getting the coefficients for tension, coefficient for moment, coefficient of for shear, all these things are based on h square by dt ratio, and the code first column will be h square by dt. Only based on h square by dt we can use the table and find out the coefficients. Therefore, h is required, d is required. H is already known to us. H is 4 meters depth of water. H is 4 meters depth of the tank. D is the diameter. That also we know, 14 meters. Thickness is not known. So, assume the thickness. Approximate thickness can be assumed. Actually, there are two different values. One is minimum 150 mm. The other formula is 30 times H plus 50. 30 times H is 30 into 4 meters. Height of depth of the tank, 4 meters. Plus 50, 170 mm. Minimum is either 150 or 170. Now, let us say 200 mm. Let us say it is 200 mm. Right. Now, we calculate the value of h square by dt, right? Based on this only, we will be able to get the coefficients. H is 4 meters, d is 14 meters, t is 0.2, 200 mm thickness, just now we have assumed. Therefore, it is 5.71. Table number 9 gives the coefficients for tension, table 10 gives coefficients for moment, and table 11 gives coefficient for shear. Previous to this, there is another table called for tank with a flexible base. Tank with, that is already discussed, right? Now, from table number 9 of IS 3370 part 4, the tension coefficient, T equal to coefficient into W into H into R kilogram per meter. This is the formula available in the code book. I will show you the table. Coefficient into W into H into R. That is kilogram per meter. When we multiply this by 10, we will get the value in terms of Newton per meter. Or directly, if you substitute W in terms of kilogram per meter cube, we will be getting the value in terms of kilogram meter per meter. When we substitute in terms of Newton straight away, we will be getting the value in terms of W. If it is directly substituted in terms of meter, Newton, you will be getting in terms of Newton per meter. So, that calculation we have to be careful, because in the formula they are given, in the code book they are given in terms of kilogram meter per meter. So, that point we have to remove. Otherwise, we will not multiply this by this 10 and we will miss the right. H square by dt equal to 7.51. For H square by dt equal to 5.71, maximum value of coefficient equal to 0.477 plus 504, and I think better we will see the code book. Yes, this is the code book. This is the code book page, table number 9. Table number 9 gives tension in circular tank, tension in circular wall, circular ring wall, fixed at base, free top, and subjected to triangular load. Subject triangle. So, our water pressure diagram is a triangular one, 0 to W into H. Therefore, and also they are given the figure, because here the letters are okay. Here it is capital D, this is capital R radius, that is a diameter capital D. So, this is not clear, right? Now, this is the height of the tank. So, this is the thickness. So, everything is given. thickness, and also the water pressure is equal to W into H. That also is marked at the bottom. So here may not be that much clear. So this is H, this is radius, this is diameter, and this is W into H, pressure water pressure diagram. This is thickness T, thickness T. Right. Now this coefficient is based on H square by dt, 0.4, 0.8, 1.2, 1.6, up to 16. Our value is 5.71. So our value will be between 5 and 6, between 5 and 6. Now for H square by dt equal to 5, what is the value? If you go like this, this is 0.025, this is 0.137, 0.245. It just goes on increasing, I think this is for 5, third value from the bottom, right? So here 0.443, third value is 0.428, 0.477, 0.469, therefore 0.469, right? So between these two values, so we have to interpolate. This is the highest value in this row. This is the highest value. One is 0.477, the other one is 0.504. So our value will be between 0.477 and 0.504. That we have to interpolate and say 0.49, some value. You have to interpolate. Interpolation is a simple thing. So, and all other values will be less. All other values will be 0.469, 398, 259, becomes mean. The highest value here is in the third value from the bottom, 1, 2, 3, this is 0.477, this is for 5, this is for 6. So between these two values, you'll have to interpolate, right? Now here, this is 0.477, 0.504. Between interpolating between these two values, we get, there is 0.496. There is another value here. The next value, this is 0.504, this is 0.514. Next value is 0.514. Either we can take that value as it is. Here this value is 0.514. Therefore, when you interpolate between these two, the value may be little higher. Therefore, that also we consider 0.469, 0.514. We interpolate and get the value. So we interpolate the next value also of the two. This is higher. We take 0.501 at 0.6H. This is the coefficient. Coefficient is equal to 0.501. Therefore, point 0.501 into W into H into R. That is the formula. We just go back to the formula once so that it is coefficient. The formula is coefficient. The formula is coefficient into So W into gives problem. This is the formula, W into H into R. So anyways, gives problem. Speed problem. So W into H into R. So W into the coefficient into W into H into R is diameter by 2 radius. So this is the calculation, and hoop tension is equal to 140,280 Newton per meter at 0.6 H from the top. Right. Now moment equal to from table 10. Moment equal to coefficient into W into H cube. W into H cube, that is this is the formula for moments in cylindrical wall, etc. Moment equal to coefficient into W into H cube. So here again, between 5 and 6 we have to interpolate. When we interpolate, that is the value will be, the highest value will be only this value, the last two values. So these are the highest values, because when you come down, so here it is 0.0041 0.0022, here it is 0.0187 0.0146. So that is the highest value in this row, that is the highest value. It is with a minus sign. So minus sign, the meaning of minus sign is given below here. W is the density of the liquid. Positive sign indicates tension on the outside. Tension on the outside. So in our case, it is negative. Negative means the tension on the inside. So why I am stressing here is, where we have to provide the steel. The steel for bending moment, whether we have to provide on the inner side or outer side. Because negative sign indicates tension on the inner side. Therefore, we have to provide the main steel on the inner side in the vertical direction. This is for the bending moment. Hoop steel, it will be in the form of circular rings. So this is for the bending moment, vertical steel. So this steel will have to be provided on the inner side. So this, we have to be very clear. We have to be very thorough. So this is the formula, coefficient W into H cube. So from the last column, we have interpolated and got the value 0.0197 is the value. So moment equal to the coefficient minus 0.0197 into 10,000 into 4 cube is 12,608 Newton meter. So negative sign indicates that the tension is on the inside. So we have to provide steel on the inner side. So that we have to write. So that is about the bending moment. Again, for shear at the base, we have this table. So this table, h square by dt, again for different values. This is for triangular load with the fixed base. This is rectangular tank with the fixed base, that is given. In our case, it is triangular load, fixed base. So this we have to use. The formula is coefficient into W into h square kilogram for triangular load, or Newton if we substitute W in terms of Newton. So we have to use the first, second column and the first formula. So that we have to, now therefore, between 5 and 6 we have to interpolate between these two values, 0.213 and 0.197. So we have to get the value. So therefore, that on interpolation, shear at the base, equal to coefficient 0.213 and 0.197. So interpolate and get the value as 0.202. So shear at the base equal to 0.202 into 10,000 into 4 square. That gives equal to 32,320 newtons. And check for thickness to resist bending. So we have got the values, the design values. We have got the tension for the design. We have got the bending moment for the design. We have got the shear for the design. Now, we have to check the thickness. The thickness of the wall, we have assumed 30H plus 50 and all those things, we have assumed. But whether the thickness will be adequate for the bending moment, we do not know. Right. Now, we are going to check the thickness. For checking the thickness, we are going to equate the bending moment to the moment of resistance. Already, we have found out the moment of resistance equal to 1.528 BD square. 1.528 BD square is the moment of resistance. That we have to equate it to the bending moment. We are doing the design by working stress method. Therefore, no partial safety factor is to be used here. So, equating bending moment. So, this is the bending moment. 12,608. Just now we have calculated the bending moment. And next is equating the bending moment to the moment of resistance. The thickness equal to 90.84. We have assumed a thickness of 200 mm. Therefore, the thickness assumed is more than the requirement. Therefore, adopt the assumed thickness. That is, we have checked the thickness. Next, we have to go for the reinforcement. Adopting a clear cover of 25 mm and 12 mm diameter bars. So, effective depth equal to 200 minus clear cover minus half the diameter of the bar, that is equal to 169 mm. That is the effective depth. So, area of steel equal to bending moment by sigma st into JD, working stress method. Bending moment by sigma st is 130, JD, lever arm, already we have got it at the beginning of the design, 0.86 into the effective depth. That gives area of steel equal to 667.3 mm square. So, minimum steel you have to check. Minimum steel is 0.24%, that comes to 480 mm square. So, our requirement is more than the minimum. Therefore, we have to adopt the requirement value, that is 667.3 mm square. Therefore, for which you have to find out the spacing. These are all routine RC design only. It is not special to RCs, water tanks. So, routine only. So, adopting 12 mm diameter bar, spacing is equal to 169.3 mm. So, provide 12 mm diameter bars at a pitch of 150 mm center center. We have to remember that we have to provide the steel in the vertical direction on the inner side where tension occurs. That alone we have to remember. Vertical direction on the inner side where tension occurs. Right. Now, coming to the next one. So, we have found out the bending moment. We have designed the thickness and also designed the reinforcement and decided where we have to provide the steel. Next is that of design for the hoop tension. Hoop tension we'll have to provide in the form of circular rings. So, hoop tension equal to 140280 Newton per meter at 0.6H as per the table. So, 0.6H, 2.4 meter from the top. Right. Now, there the steel required is tension divided by sigma ST, that's all. Tension divided by sigma ST. Sigma ST is 130. Therefore, the steel required equal to 1079 mm square. So, spacing is equal to spacing of 16 mm diameter bars is equal to area of 1 bar into 1000 by AST required. Let us say 160 mm center to center. So, these are the rings. So, provide these rings on both faces of the wall at a spacing of 320 mm center to center. 320 mm is too much, but still when you combine put together, the bars are available to 160 mm because left hand side it is 0, right hand side 160. Left hand side 320 at 48, like that. Therefore, practically the bars are available at 160 mm center to center. But on each face we are providing a double the spacing, that's all. Double the spacing alternatively. 0 left, 160 on the right, 320 left, like that. Therefore, that will practically, it will be available to 160 mm center to center. So this will be, this is for the maximum tension. Maximum tension at 0.6 H from the top. And H, here we have taken H equal to 4 meters. Now, as discussed earlier, when you go towards the top, the tension will become less because H is less, therefore the tension will be less. Though the steel requirement will also will be less. Therefore, either you can provide the same diameter of bar at increased spacing, or we can go for lesser diameter of bar and maintain more or less the same spacing. Therefore, that is the next part. Next part is that of hoop tension at 0.6 H from the top is same coefficient into 10,000 into 2.4. In the place of 4, we have substituted 2.4, and this is the tension. Again, for this steel, for this tension. Now we go for 10 mm diameter bars, 121 mm center to center. Therefore, about 2.4, the top 2.4 meters. From 2.4 to 4 meters at the bottom, we have provided 16 mm diameter bar. For the top 2.4 meters, 10 mm diameter bars will be provided to 200 mm center to center on both faces alternatively. On the outer side, because we have provided the main steel on the inner side where tension occurs. So, on the outer side, to hold the hoop reinforcement, you have to provide vertical bars. So, on the outer side, vertical steel will be provided, vertical steel of 12 mm diameter will be provided at a pitch of 200 mm center to center to hold the hoop steel in position. So, that is about the design of the reinforcement for the hoop tension, bending moment, and shear. Shear we have not designed because normally the shear at the base will be very negligible, but we can always find out. The formula is there, tau V equal to V by BD, and allowable stresses are given in the code. So if the stress will be very, very less than the compare, the allowable value is given in the form of a table. Tau V equal to V by BD. IS 456 design, I guide you step by step for the design of the shear. I think that will be negligible, therefore we have just dropped. That also can be done if necessary, right? Or if asked. So, usual procedure given in the IS code 456 only. So, that's about the tank with a fixed bottom. So, for this also we have to show the reinforcement details. Time being, it's not with me. I'll just take it up in a future class. We'll discuss how to provide that. Of course, part by part we have discussed. Only thing is, we have to assemble all these things, including base slab reinforcement. I have shown a drawing. And here also, the base slab has not been designed. Because same design, same tank. Therefore, nominal thickness, nominal reinforcement. So, what you have discussed in the case of a tank with a hinged base, same thickness and same reinforcement. The only difference is the reinforcement for the side wall and reinforcement for the base slab will be monolithic. There is no joint as in the previous case. And coming to the reinforcement for the dome slab, we have already discussed. Coming to the reinforcement of the side wall also, we have discussed. Only thing is, we have to assemble everything and see as a full drawing. So, we have discussed all these things individually and also discussed the drawing. So, that is as far as the drawing is concerned. Because drawing is actually more important. Drawing is more important. Right? And next is, we have to discuss overhead tanks, and then we have to discuss underground tanks. Right. Now, in the case of overhead tank we are going to take it up later. But what I am going to discuss now is, we have discussed a tank with a fixed base and also a tank with a hinged base. So, that is not going to be stopped there. That is going to be applied to overhead tanks also. So, overhead tank where we have to use the hinged base condition, where we have to use the fixed base. fixed base condition, right? Overhead tank or ESR. ESR stands for elevated service reservoir. OHT stands for overhead tank. Now the overhead tanks may be resting on a masonry wall, resting on a masonry wall all round, or resting on columns like this, resting on columns like this, or resting on columns like this with a bottom dome. Right, now when it is resting on the masonry wall, the circular wall of the tank will be designed for rigid base condition. Here the side wall and that of the base slab, here it will be treated as fixed. At the base, the base of the tank wall will be treated as fixed. The end of the slab will also be treated as fixed. Therefore, whatever we have designed just now, that is tank with a fixed base, the same procedure is applicable to this. Therefore, that will be repeated here. We are not going to learn a new procedure here, same design procedure, tank with a fixed base, right? So next, this one. Now here, it is with a sloping bottom and then a bottom slab, etc. Right. Now, here that tank will be designed for hoop tension as we have designed previously. That is tank with a flexible base. So this side wall will be designed as a tank with a flexible base. And a check for compressive stress. Actually, this wall will be designed only for hoop tension as earlier. Either you can go for nominal vertical reinforcement, or we can find out the compressive stress. What is the total force? What is the area? Find out the compressive stress. You will find that the compressive stress will be very, very less than the allowable stress. Therefore, you are going to design nominal vertical steel. So, same tank with a flexible base. And also here, the circular slab will be treated as supported all round. So now, here it is not fixed. Supported all round. So, the base slab is not fixed all round, and also the tank bottom is not fixed. It is hinged. Similarly, the next tank also, this is called as the inch tank. We have a top dome, we have a bottom dome, and we have tapering side wall, conical wall. So here also, so designed for hoop tension only, as we have discussed. Tank with a hinged base, same thing will be repeated here. You are not going to learn anything new here, same procedure will have to repeat. So I am just giving you the importance of the tank. Tanks already we have designed, tank with the hinged base and tank with the fixed base. That will be simply repeated here, So any book will just give the design, and if you go through, the same procedure will be there, right. So here also tank with the hoop will be designed for hoop tension, and check for compressive stress. Check for compressive stress is also not required because the stress will be very low. We can go for nominal vertical steel, or if necessary, the force divided by area will give you the stress, and therefore you can say, you can conclude the stress is much less than the allowable stress, therefore we will go for nominal vertical steel. Because in the tank, for a tank with a hinged base, the main force is hoop tension, the main steel is that of the rings, that's all, right? So that, and here also we have designed the dome slab, whether it is a ground level tank or underground tank or elevated tank, the dome slab design is same, will not be repeated. So in each and every design we have to understand what is new in this, because every design will not require a new concept. So what are all common to different types of structures that you have. And here also there is another dome. So this dome, the forces will be different, that's all. So here only live load and dead load, here water load and all other things are to be considered. Anyway, we are going to take up a problem on this and we will discuss later. So this discussion is only to say that the tank with a flexible base and tank with a rigid base will be repeated here. So that is the importance of this design, and other things we will discuss later. And let me complete this lecture with this. Thank you all.